students, I am Hemlata Singh, computer teacher. Today I will teach you class 10, lesson 2, computers and communication. Students, you know the communication means transfer any information to one person to another person. In general life, we communicate to each other, but we send some message to our friends and they also send the message to others. These are form of communication. So, in terms of data communication, what is data communication? Data communication is the movement of encoded information from one point to another by means of electrical or optical transmission system. So, system of in our car, data communication network. Means the data communication, in other words you can say that data communication means transmitting of data between one computer to another computer is called data communication. There are so many benefits of data communication. These are in data communication, collect data from remote points and transmit that data to a central point, vice versa. It facilitate more efficient use of central computer, and it improve day-to-day control of business by providing faster information flow, and it provide message switching services to allow terminal to talk to one another and bring power of computer closer to user, and it offer better and timely interchange of data among users. So these are some main benefits of data communication. There are so many benefits of data communication. Now, usage of data communication, the source data entry and collection, real-time interactive network, we use data communication, remote job entry, we use data collection, information retrieval, and conversational time sharing, message switching, etc. All are the usage of data communication. There are five basic components of data communication. These are sender, receiver, message, media and protocol. Here sender is the originator who sends the message. Sender is a electronic device device which is responsible for sending mass information, that is telephone, computer, mobile, etc. All are sender. Sender means that device which send the messages to receiver is called sender. And second is our component is receiver, because these components are main component of data communication. If there is absence of any component, data communication not possible. So second one is receiver. Receiver, it is used to accept signals of communication system and convert them in understandable form. Generally receiver is a computer with modem, and receiver accepts received messages sent by sender. So sender, the device which sends the messages, and receiver which receive the message sent by sender. And message any information, that sent by sender is called message. Message in any type of message, it may be any image, it may be any file, folder, etc. All are message. It may be any notice. So sender sends message. If there will be sender and receiver, but absence of message, they will not communicate to each other. So message is necessary for data communication. Now media. Media is the path. Which is used to send messages by sender and accept receiver. it is the path through which the message flows is called media. And media are two types, guided media and unguided media. You can say that wireless, wired media and wireless media. Now, protocol. If we will do any work, any type of work, there is any organization or any management, we need some rules to follow to do our messages. So here protocol also some rules. When on network communication possible using protocol. Protocol are the rules which followed by network. So protocol, some set of rules. It is used in communication network, communication network. So communication protocol is a software which are used to establish communication between several computers. It defines the exact order in which two machines exchange data with one another. Protocols are technical customs or guidelines that govern the exchange of signals, transmission and reception between equipment. Each protocol specifies the exact order in which signals will be transferred. More hardware and software designed to handle a specific protocol. There are some functions of protocol. How to begin and terminate a session between two computers. How the message in a session are to be formed. How errors in transmission of message are to be detected. How messages are to be transferred when errors are detected. So protocols provide some functions. How to find out which message block was sent by which terminal computer and to whom. How to dialogue on the communication line proceed. All are the role of protocol. Now some types of protocol. Main protocol, there are so many protocols, but some main protocols which is necessary for data communication: TCP/IP, full form of TCP is transmission, control, protocol. And IP means internet protocol. It is the main protocol of in any data communication. TCP breaks up the data to be sent into packets. It guarantees that any data sent to the destination computer reaches it. IP, so transmission control, transmission control breaks up the data to be sent into packets, and it guarantees that the data sent to the destination computer reaches it. And IP, internet protocol, it is a set of conventions used to send packets from one host to another. It is responsible for routing the packets to a desired destination IP address. Internet protocol is provide IP address to send messages. And here another is X.212 protocol. X.12 protocol, this protocol is used to establish connection between companies to exchange important papers. There are different types of protocols and they follow different rules to send messages. And next is X.25 protocol. This protocol establishes the interface for common data network. Next is HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The full form of HTTP is Hypertext Transfer. Hypertext transfer protocols works in internet to send or receive files from different locations. So these are the components of data communication. They play the main role in data communication, and we can show data communication with this figure. Diagram of sender who sent the messages, and this is message sent by sender, and this is transmission media. This carry message and we provide path to computer, and this is receiver who received the message sent by sender, and it also follow the rules of protocol. That's all for today.